him, for the hymnless kids with no religion. Yeah, we keep on sinning. Yeah, we keep on singing.
Hello, everybody. Welcome back to my channel. I'm going to be filming two videos, so if I'm wearing like the same shit, that is why. But yeah, so this particular video was actually requested. I had this in another video planned, but I did a poll on my Instagram, and this is the one that got the most votes. So yeah, I'm going to show you guys me going back to my seniors. Like, I already made an album on my phone here of all of the photos and stuff like that, so I'm gonna have it like shown here on the side of the screen here so you guys can see. So yeah, without further ado, let's go ahead and get started. If you guys don't mind, go ahead, click that subscribe button down below. That would mean everything to me. And if you guys like this video, make sure you give it a big thumbs up for me as well. And yeah, let's go ahead and get started. Alright guys, so I'm also going to be having some music playing in the background of the type of music that I would be listening to during my little time fiasco during this age. I mean, I obviously still listen to this type of music, but I'm not involved as with the style. Obviously, I've moved towards like the piercing, like kind of like the alternative style, but I don't know, just a me, I guess. So yeah, right when it was like the tail end of my, my junior year of high school is when I really started getting into it. So obviously, like, this time was probably like a little bit off of like the scene phase. I'm gonna put that in quotes, scene phase. But yeah, so I'm just gonna do like a little screen recording here. So yeah, perfect. Okay, so as you guys can see, I have like my album here. Obviously, I wrote like senior, so I literally pulled all of these photos off of my Facebook. And yeah, because obviously anyone who's friends with me on Facebook can literally access these photos, but I'm literally thinking about putting these photos so that way only, you know, I'm able to see them. Because, I mean, a lot of these pictures are, like, pretty embarrassing. I'm not really too sure why or when I thought this was even remotely cool or anything like that, but yeah. So, this is the first picture. It took me a really, really long time to start doing my hair like this. I will show you guys on my actual Facebook here when I started transitioning into that here. And I was on my profile the whole entire time. So I'm hoping that this picture is in my album. So I started doing this phase I want to say like October 2011, and I actually started getting my hair cut like this certain way here. Which I don't really know why I didn't include it in here, but so yeah, let's see. This photo was done October 16th, 2011. So yeah, I actually started getting my hair cut just like this. It was a picture of Christina Grimmie. If y'all don't know who she is, she actually ended up dying about a little over a year ago. She was a really, really good singer. She actually ended up getting shot while she was on tour, and I absolutely loved everything about her. So I'll like show you guys a picture here. So that way y'all can like see how I had my hair. Like, I was literally obsessed with how she had her hair. I feel like a lot of these are so up to date, but I literally had my hair cut literally just like this. It was like short layers up top and then really long on down here. So yeah, literally just like a mullet. So if you ever want seen hair, literally just ask for a mullet with bangs. Literally, it's the way to go about it. So at this time I was literally trying to train my bangs. Here's another picture for you guys. I was also wearing these like little like coontail extension things. If y'all don't know what they are, they're literally these extensions that you could get from like Hot Topic or Amazon or eBay. But yeah, they are literally these type of extensions. So I had, I do believe I had a green one, I had a purple one, I also had a lavender one, and I do believe I had a pink one. So I had four of them all together. But I just thought it would be like so cool. Be like, oh my god, like, you know, that type of thing. So I'm just gonna keep going. So this is another picture that I did. I also had like the single colored hair extensions that you could buy from Hot Topic at the time too. I had purple, blue, pink, green, and I do believe I had black at one point too. But yeah, they were just like single colored like strip extensions. They're maybe like 14 inches long, probably like here. And yeah, so I had those in my hair. Because at the time, like, my parents were like, no, you're not dyeing your hair. Like, the only time you're ever gonna dye your hair is if it's, like, natural color. So, like, blonde, brown, and yeah, I never was able to do black either. But I also went through, like, that, like, rebel kind of stage, too, to where, like, I really didn't care. And that's kind of helped me grow into this person that I am today. But going back, so obviously this is really, really cringe-worthy, this photo right here. I'd be like, I really don't know what I was thinking. And this is also the point where I started doing my eye makeup really, really like heavy and smoky. Literally, I would just take an eyeliner, and the ones that I would use were the Rimmel London like pencil eyeliners. Or like the ones from like Wet n Wild, which I'm pretty sure I ended up throwing mine out, which I did. But anyway, so I literally took whatever pencil eyeliner I could find, and I would take an eyeshadow brush and literally just smudge it. And then at the time I really had this cheap, I think it was like 30 color eyeshadow palette that had like different colors, and I literally took black eyeshadow and yeah, I started doing like raccoon type eyes. And of course my recording room is soft. Why you gotta be like this? Okay. So, yeah, this was literally the time where I started doing that with my eye makeup. So, and of course I would do like the spider lashes a lot. Like I would literally, on average, when I was in high school, I actually did a video of how I did my mascara when I was in high school, and I literally, I kid you not, did 7 to 8 layers of mascara every single day because I really liked how they look. So here's just another picture with this transitioning. I actually started to tease my hair, and I thought it'd be super cute like at my parting where my bangs was. I bought like this really, really cute bow, and I literally wore my hair like that to school. Yes, I wore my hair like that to school. This was also the same stage where I started to dye my hair blonde the first time. And at the time I was just using hair dye. I wasn't even using bleach at all. I do believe I was using the Revlon, whatever, it's like Revlon like Color Stay or something like that, like the hair dye, like the lightest blonde that you can possibly buy, and that's what I was using on my brown hair. So again, here's another picture of that, and again, here is a close-up of the way that I did my eye makeup, and again, it was like very raccoonish, and at the time, I literally thought if I did my eye makeup like this, it made my eyes look bigger, when in reality, it made them quite small, and I actually have like pretty big eyes already. So I was like, oh, like, let's just make them bigger, but in reality, it made them, like, really, really small. So this was also another pose that I did, like, quite often. And I started wearing a lot of friendship bracelets a lot. And I was also doing, this was also the time where the crackle nail polish was coming out, so I did that. And yeah. So the picture after this, so this is when I was actually able to convince my dad, which I was living with at the time, that I really wanted to dye the underneath of my bangs purple. So I figured if it was the underneath, it wouldn't really be so bad. So basically I bought the Splat, I do believe the shade is Lusty Lavender, which they still currently make, and I ended up with this color. So, and of course I was wearing like the extension piece that you guys can clearly see right there, and of course the severely smoky eye. So I basically did the underneath of my bangs, and I also, you guys can see on the left side of my face that I tried to do a coontail in my actual hair. So, and again, here's another picture, and of course this is where I started to dye my hair blonde, of course, and I started to do my own bangs, and then yes, I was cutting my own hair. So this is the stage shortly right after where I actually started to bleach my own hair, and of course you can still see the pink that, well, the Lusty Lavender shade that is still in my hair right here, right in the center, and I was like, oh my god, that, like, that looks so cute, but no, it looked really, really stupid, and of course I'm still going with the raccoon eye here. So here is another picture of how I started doing my bangs. Again, like I said, I was literally cutting my hair by myself. And again, here's another picture of the side. Basically how I did cut it was I was cutting it kind of like upwards, if that makes sense. So that way it made it like spiky. And then the type of hairspray that I was using the Got To Be Glued hairspray. And basically I would spray it in my fingers and I would basically like pull it, so that way it would get like that side type of fringe going on. And again, here's another picture, and here's where I started to collect the candy bracelets. And yeah. Alrighty, so this picture was literally, I think it was like a week or two after my junior prom. I actually bought this hair color. This is probably between this color and the Ion Color Brilliance Brights, I think that's what the thing is that I use is called. This is Jerome Russell's Punky Color. This particular hair dye is only available at Ulta, and I do believe on the Jerome Russell Color website. But yeah, this color is in the shade Plum, which is the darkest purple that they have. But since because I was bleaching my hair literally all the time, it was literally white. So by the time that I put the purple in my hair, it made the blonde bits of my hair silver. But of course the purple was like bright purple. Like, I kid you not, it was like the most beautiful purple like I ever had. Like, I loved my hair like this. And of course you can see I literally just did like my fringe, and of course a coontail. I was really deeply inspired by this hair queen. At the time her name was Hannah Hacksaw, I do believe was her scene name. She was from Norwich, England, and yeah, I was just really deeply inspired by her hair, so I was like, oh my god, I'm gonna do it, and my parents gave me the okay. So I literally had my hair like this for about a month, and then bam, black hair. So after I had the purple in my hair and of course the silver, my hair, when I put the black hair dye on my hair, it turned a dramatic blue navy color. So even though in the picture it looks black, I kid you not, it was like navy blue. And here's like a better picture that you guys can see, and of course I'm wearing the candy bracelets, that you guys can see that the black in my hair has a blue pigment. So this is also the start where I started wearing like black eyeliner up top, and then I was wearing purple on the bottom. If I wasn't doing that, then I was doing purple on top and then purple on the bottom. One of my first YouTube tutorials was literally how to wear colored eyeliner. Basically what I was doing was I was taking, you could literally do any purple eyeliner. The one that I was using was from Jessie's Girl, which is still available at Rite Aid. I do believe it's like grape soda or like something like that, but it's a pencil eyeliner. And I would do what, instead of putting black, I would do purple, and then I would just put purple eyeshadow right on top and then put mascara, and then I was done. So if I wasn't wearing black, then I was definitely wearing purple. So again, here's another picture here, and of course the nerd glasses were definitely a thing. Again, here's honestly, like, I'm not really cringing at this photo, like, at all. Like, I think this is probably the cutest photo out of, like, my whole entire scene phase. of course, still wearing the candy bracelets. And let me know in the comments down below if you guys remember the, like, I Love Boobies bracelets, because I remember everyone in my high school, like, had them. Like, there would be, like, black, green, pink, blue, like, and you could only get them from, I think it was Zoomies. So yeah, let me know in the comments down below if you guys had one of them bracelets. Alright, so now we are entering the start of my senior year of high school. So, of course, I was still working the black hair, and of course I updated my little nerd glasses. Like, I actually bought a pair from Hot Topic, and yeah, they actually had like zebra print on the inside, and I really, really loved them. And of course, candy bracelets. And I do believe the shirt that I was wearing was a Skylet Drive shirt. I do believe it was them and Sleeping with Sirens that I really like just got hardcore into. So again, here's like another picture. I was using my webcam on my camera on my laptop at the time, and I was using this, like, I think it was like Cam Wow or something like that. This website was recently like taken down because of like so many people were hacking it and stuff like that, to see like people like taking selfies. Or it was like Camstar or something like that. But yeah, so that's how I basically did these. This one was actually like one of my favorites as well. I just thought, like, they're just so much fun to, like, do. Alrighty, so shortly after, I want to say, oh my goodness, so I totally missed, like, pictures here. So, after I had my hair black my senior year, I went through a really, really bad downfall, like a really bad breakup. So I ended up bleaching the black out of my hair, and I dyed my hair like bright Little Mermaid hair red. I literally did not take any photos at this time. I'm pretty sure, like I said, it was like a really, really bad time. Yeah, I'm not even gonna bother looking. But yeah, so I had my hair red, and then I dyed it brown. So and of course I ended up cutting my hair as well. So this is where we are at now. So this is about March of 2013. So yeah, I had this, and about, I want to say a month after that, so, or April now, I started to do like a red tint. So basically I was buying like semi-permanent red hair dye, which I do believe I was using the Splat Luscious Raspberries on top of the brown hair dye. There we go. And that's how I was getting this type of hair color, which I really, really loved. And of course, these are literally the same thing. I started changing up my makeup the way I did that as well. Basically, I'm trying to think if I had made a video on this makeup look. But basically what I was doing was I was taking any silver eyeshadow. Of course, I still had the silver that I was using from high school. This is the L'Oreal Infallible Eyeshadow in Silver Sky. So this is the silver eyeshadow I've been using since high school. Like, I refuse to get rid of it. It's kind of like a memory thing. I mean, I'm pretty sure it's expired, but I just kind of refuse to get rid of it. So this photo right here is literally, like I said, I felt like I literally looked like a skunk. And this is also about the same time I started experimenting with winged eyeliner and white on the bottom. Alright, so this picture was, I do believe, a day after Warped Tour. You guys can a little bit kind of tell that I have blue in my hair now where the blonde was. And again, there's another picture, of course, winged eyeliner. So here's a better picture where you guys can see where the blue is. And there's another one. It's kind of like cringe-worthy. So this photo, I do believe I had dyed my hair back to brown because at this point I was like, oh my god, I'm going to be going to college. I can't have like blue hair. So I dyed all of my hair brown, and of course I am wearing a Sleeping with Siren shirt that my sister now owns. So here's another picture, and of course I'm wearing my Skylit Drive t-shirt. I literally love that t-shirt. I really, really wish that at Hot Topic they would literally make the t-shirts like that. So if you guys know what I'm talking about, please. So again, Sleeping with Sirens t-shirt, and of course the silver eye with like the raccoon-ness and the very long eyelashes. So here I started doing a purple eyeshadow with a winged eyeliner. Don't mind my very terrible brows. So there's that photo. So this was, I do believe, right when I started my freshman year of college. I started messing with extensions again, so I started wearing my purple color hair extensions. Like, I literally wore them like every day. I felt like super like empty, like it was kind of missing from me. So yeah, I started doing that, and of course I started stretching my ears at this point. So sadly, I currently took out my gauges, but my ears have not closed at all. I mean, all the way. I could literally, I do have a 10 gauge taper that I can literally shove through, like, no problem. So, but I am not gonna lie, I really, really miss my plugs. So, thinking about bringing them back because I kind of miss them, and I feel like they kind of like made me like, but I took them out because I thought like they weren't really, really like professional-ish. Oh my gosh, my screen keeps coming out. I'm so sorry, guys. So yeah, so there's that photo. So we're just gonna keep going. This is literally like the same time. And this is the time like I had taken out that colored piece, and I literally curled my bangs like this, and of course I literally wore winged liner every day. And this is also the time where I started to do my own eyebrows. So definitely cringeworthy. Definitely don't recommend doing that. This is also the start where I started to do actual hair extensions. So because when I was in high school, I literally dyed my hair constantly, so my hair unfortunately has become damaged and it has become thinned out. I used to have really, really thick hair, but now it's like super thin. So yeah, like the thin hair extensions actually worked for me. So these were, I do believe, I actually bought these off of eBay. They were 18 inches, and then I do believe they were 100 grams. They're like 80 or 100 grams, but I actually loved them. Like, they lasted for like ever. We are now at the start of my second semester of my freshman year of college, and of course, I wanted to dye my hair back to blonde. So as you guys can see, my hair is severely fried at the ends, and yeah, it's disgusting, brassy nastiness. So at this point, this was, I want to say about April-ish or March-ish, when I was actually able to get my hair like this kind of color, but it was just a little bit lighter, and I actually bought blonde hair extensions. These ones were a little bit thicker. These were 20 or 22 inches, and these were 125 grams. So basically what I did, you guys can kind of see, but I did blue, teal, pink, and purple in the end, so it was kind of like unicorn-ish. And of course, here we go with the raccoon eyes again, which I really love my hair like this. So, this is like one of my natural days. So, here's like another, like a better picture of the hair extensions, and of course I was starting to wear the winged liner that I am now famous for. Alright, so this picture, and of course, like I said, I literally started being obsessed with winged liner. So when I started doing winged liner, like, my wings were like thick. So as you guys can see in this photo, they were pretty thick here. So there's that, and in this photo I'm actually wearing a You're Not Alone shirt from Of Mice and Men. Oh. Alright, so right at the end of my freshman year of college, I was like, you know what, why not? I'm just gonna try and tone my hair. So at this point I was like, I had purple hair dye and I mixed it in with conditioner. Left it in my hair and this is what I got. I literally had lavender hair. So that's how I got that, and I actually really, really loved it. So we are now at summertime for this part. I literally started messing around with more like neutral, like brown, like smoky eyes. So that's what I was doing. And here is another photo here. Oh gosh, I feel like there's something in the room. And here's another picture with my hair extensions. Probably about mid-summer 2014. I had dyed just a strip of teal in my hair and I thought it was like super cute. Alrighty, so we are now at, I want to say, end of July, beginning of August, and I was like, you know what, I'm going to dye my hair Little Mermaid bright hair red again. So I used the Splat Luscious Raspberry color, and of course I'm wearing that thick winged liner. I loved it, and I thought it was like super cute, but the downfall with this color was the more times I washed it, the pinker it got. Believe it or not, when I met my husband, it was this color. So yeah. Here is another picture of me with brown hair. I was like, you know what, I gotta go back to school. So I dyed my hair back to brown. I added a few highlights, and of course I'm still rocking that scene hair look. And here's a better picture here. Of course, the spider lashes, can't get rid of those. Oh no. There's another picture here. And then right at October-ish, I decided to dye my hair black. So I did that. And there's some like older photos. And now I'm here. So yeah. Alright guys, so hopefully you enjoyed this video. Hopefully you had some laughs. I know I did because I'm like, hey, I don't want to put those photos away. I want to like forget that I even did a phase like that. But I'm actually kind of glad because I am still obsessed with the music. Like I still listen to Sleeping with Sirens. I'm really upset that it is the last band Warped Tour. But, I feel like if I didn't go through, like, that phase, I would not be who I am today. So, if you guys made it this far, go ahead and give this video a big thumbs up for me. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye!